One of the dishes that really made an imprint on me is the nasi kandar. It's the ultimate worker man's meal that features rice, meat, and tons of sauce. It's something I believe all Pinoys would love too. In fact, it reminds me of how a lot of Pinoys love steak with loads of gravy and rice. My next dish is a hat tip to that.
I'm just gonna start with some of our aromatics. So instead of a regular steak brown gravy, I'm gonna make sort of Penang style gravy. So I'm gonna use some ginger and then some galangal as well. So we don't need everything. So I'm gonna tear off one piece like that. And what you want to do is just take away the skin here. I've got the ginger ready as well. I've also got some peeled garlic. So these will be the flavor base of our gravy. All right, so I'm gonna sear the steak first because I want that flavor from the steak to come through on the gravy as well. You know, part of the reason why the nasi kandar gravies are so good is because it's cooked with the meat. To get a really nice sear on the steak, you get a paper towel and just pat these dry.
I then season with some salt and pepper.
Oil is ready, smoking just a little bit now. You get our steak. Just gently lay that down, like so. And now is a good time to season the other side. Again, just salt and pepper. Usually with steak, I just like salt and pepper. I don't want those fancy rubs. These are pretty thick cuts, so you can afford to leave them there for a while. Let the color go up first. So it's gonna look half cooked, and then you turn them over. And we should get a really nice crust like that. Beautiful. Okay, when we started cooking this, the oil was really hot, right? But we put in the steak. So it's not as hot as before. That means it's the perfect time to add some butter, right? So just get about maybe a good heaping tablespoon of butter, like that. And just put that into our pan. And I'm gonna add a little bit more butter. Now, what's gonna happen now is you're gonna get lots of oil now. It's just the olive oil and the butter together, right? So what I want to do now is tilt the pan. Grab some of this beautiful liquid and just baste our steaks in it. So what's gonna happen is our steaks will stay moist and juicy. All of that butter flavor in there. Oh my goodness. I'm already excited and we're not even in the gravy part yet. Ah, beautiful. Okay, checking the steaks now. Yeah, that's a pretty good medium right now, so I'm gonna shut off the heat. I'm gonna take the steaks out and I'm gonna let them rest first. You know, I really like things that are hot off the grill, but listen, when you're eating steak, you want to let it rest. Okay, right now all of the juices, they're like going around because it's so hot, right? You seared it so hot, so all the juices are running around. You gotta let them calm down first. And when they calm down, they spread back out all over the steak. Makes it really juicy.
To the pan of flavorful oil and butter, I add in even more flavors. This time, some ginger, galangal, and garlic.
Okay, that's it. Now I'm gonna heat up the pan again. This time with all of our aromatics. So by this time, the oil is not as hot. That way, we're infusing it with all of these beautiful aromatic flavors. And then to this, I'm gonna add some coconut. So they use a lot of coconut here in Penang. So of course, we have to use some. So you're gonna put a couple of handfuls of that. Oh wow, this smells really good. You know what, I like things spicy, so I'm gonna add a little bit of chili powder. Let's toast this now. You won't believe the aroma that's coming out right now. All right, once it's smelling really good, we add a little bit of flour. This is basically our roux. So we have the fat in there and now the flour. So if you take a look now, it's a little bit lumpy, right? It's almost like the start of any French sauce or any American gravy.
I add in some chicken stock. Water would work, of course, but stock adds more flavor.
So if you take a look at the color, right? It's a beautiful brown gravy. That's because we took the time to really toast all the coconut, the flour, the ginger, the garlic. At this point, it looks like the perfect consistency, right? But it's actually very hot. So if it gets cold, it's gonna thicken up. So I'm gonna add a little bit more. Now that's gonna be perfect.
I lower the heat to simmer the gravy, and I take to slicing the steaks.
Gravy is there. I'm just gonna add a touch of coconut milk, not too much. It's not really a curry, more of a gravy, so. Yeah, it should be good, about 1/4 cup.
The color is amazing.
And that's pretty much it. I wanna shut off the heat now. I don't wanna break up that coconut milk. And then we're gonna plate. So basically, again, this is my ode to Nasi Kandar. So I've got rice in there. I'm just gonna dump all of that beef on top and then just pour all of the sauce over it. This isn't really that pretty dish. This is that really yummy dish.